characters are coming back? And the answer is all of them. Literally all of them. If they've been in Super Smash Bros. Before, they're back in this game. Pichu, Wolf, Cloud, Sonic, Snake, Bayonetta, Young Link, Toon Link, Wolf, all of them are back. Ice Climbers, Ryu, they're all back. If they've been in Smash Bros., they're in this game. Pokemon Trainer with Squirtle, Ivysaur, and Charizard, everyone is back. Literally everyone is in the game now. That's part of the reason why it's Ultimate. They also did, a number of new characters as well. But everyone is in there. So for the new characters, they showed was what they considered Echo characters. What we called clones, they called Echo characters. Where, like, it's same but slightly different. And they announced a new Echo character, which was Princess Daisy. So an Echo of Princess Peach, Daisy will be her own thing. And a couple new things was, they said that 8-player Smash is still coming back. All stages now have both a final destination and a battlefield form. The damage percentages now have a decimal point to them, which I thought was interesting. I don't know how much that'll make a tangible difference, but to the competitive people, that'll probably make a big difference to know precisely how much damage their different attacks do. The assist trophies also come back, only now for a lot of them. You can actually attack them and knock them out and get a point for that. So you're not defenseless against Smash trophies. You can now beat them up, unless they like fly to the background or the foreground or whatever. And Bomberman is now an assist trophy, which is awesome, because we talked about having Bomberman as a possible playable character, but lacked a moveset. So him showing up as an assist trophy, that makes sense. GameCube controllers are also going to be compatible for Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. I don't know how they'll make it so you can do 4 or 2 GameCube adapters for 8 players. That's on the assumption that you use the same one as the Wii U version, but I don't know. GameCube controllers are still absolutely compatible on Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. And then the final big reveal they had at the end of all of that was another brand new character. So even though it's Ultimate, everyone's returning, they're still having new characters. And the first new character they showed was Ridley from Metroid. I was wrong about this. I actually said, like, I don't think they'll do Ridley. I don't think it'll make sense or look good. I was wrong. They made it make sense, and he looks good. Even though he's got, like, tiny little wings, he's, like, very small and hunched over all the time, so he's not, like, just towering over all the other characters. But his moveset looks really cool. He straight up murders people. I don't know if you saw that, but his, like, down B tail attack, they said, like, just stabs through people and does some damage, but it has a sweet spot on it where if they get it just right, it just impales them. They take, like, 50 damage, and they crumple over and die. Not actually die, they just, like, pass out, but it looks like Ridley just kills people. They also tweaked everyone's final smashes so that there's not as many like there's no transformation ones anymore. Like it's just like a single effect or single use. Link's now Breath of the Wild Link, so his moveset's been tweaked a little bit. His final smash has been changed. Zelda went from Princess Zelda to Link Between Worlds Zelda. There were so many character tweaks and adjustments. I'm not even going to bother trying to talk about all of them. It's better if you just watch the video because there's so much. Now, one of the things I actually really liked about Super Smash Bros. Ultimate is that they are still tweaking the gameplay and the engine itself compared to 4U. For Wii U. So, for Wii U. So, for example, 3D dodging in midair is back. So now when you do the dodge, you actually can move in a certain direction again for just a little bit more distance than trying to recover or going anywhere. There's now diminishing returns on dodges. So if you dodge over and over and over again, your invulnerability window decreases, which is awesome. Help with that spam of dodging all the time. The show talked about the decimal percentages again. A lot of item tweaks. A lot of character tweaks. Again, I'm not gonna talk about the character tweaks because there's just so freaking many. It's not worth my time. And then they ended with the date, which is December 7th this year. And that was it. So it was a very brief conference, and Super Smash Bros. Did, you know, take up a lot of the time there. I get why, though. And overall, it was still good. It was solid. Like I said, I felt I was personally more excited about a lot of stuff before the show of Smash Brothers than Smash itself, because, you know, I enjoy Smash, I like it, but it's still not a wholly brand new, mind-blowing game with like new game modes or anything. It's just the Ultimate version is cool. Like, I want to play Snake again and the different links and whatever. What I do know is how many people were just pissed off, just mad, just raging at Nintendo, because they're like, why didn't you show Metroid Prime 4? Why didn't you show Pokemon? Why didn't you show Animal Crossing? Why didn't you show F-Zero? And I kind of talked about this before in the previous video, or teased about it a little bit. The thing is, you can't get mad at them for what they didn't show, because that was your own expectation and not what they're bringing to you. You have